History of boxing, you've seen these melees up there with Zab and Mayweather, I think, and other fighters. What was it like to be involved in it and a smack in the middle of it?
I mean, it feels good because, like, I've been jumped before in the streets. I've been, hey, this crew wants to fight this crew. I went to go play in somebody else's playground, play against them in football, and we got in a fight. I've been in other people's territory and fought before. This ain't nothing new to me. So this don't scare me, man. Like, I seen the biggest loudmouth people don't ever do nothing. You see me, I never talk. I'm just quiet. I let my dad do the talking. I back it up because they say a dog, the bark don't bite.
What do you say? Danny, the Barclays was going to be already possibly...
My dad barks and bites, though.
The Barclays was going to be already possibly a hostile crowd, maybe a pro-Judah crowd because of his fans.
Yeah.
Do you think that this may have now just amplified that even more?
Hey, I hope so, man. We need that place sold out. I need the whole Brooklyn to come see him get his butt whipped. I need the whole Brooklyn. I'm about to make Brooklyn my new home, the Barclays Center.
You are a very big junior middleweight. This is my first time. Junior welterweight.
Yeah.
You look more like a junior middleweight.
Yeah.
How many fights do you think you're going to have at this weight class before you move up?
I don't know, man. That's a good question. I make the weight good. My legs feel good when I'm in the ring. I mean, after this fight, I probably only need two more fights. It's good for me out there. So I don't know, maybe I fight a couple more and then move up in weight.